digging wells seem to discover of water. In fact, you remember that the Hebrew text in the Bible, when Isaac finds water, is called Mayim Chayim. For Isaac's sake, do not receive water. Remember Jacob, who with staff in hand crossed the Jordan water. His heart trusted when he rolled the stone off of the well of water, when he wrestled with the priest of fire and water. You promised to be with him through fire and water. For Jacob's sake, do not receive water. Remember Moses, who was drawn out from the water, who drew for us and for our sheep water. When your chosen people thirsted for water, he struck the rock and out came water. For Moses' sake, do not receive water. Remember the 12 tribes you brought across. You sleep before them in the midst of water. For your sake was the blood of their descendants spilled like water. Turn to us, for our lives are encircled by our enemies like water. For Israel's sake, do not receive water. Remember Messiah Yeshua, who cried out on the last great day to speak to the people of the coast, saying, "Many men are thirsty, let us come to me and drink. He that believes in me, from his innermost being shall flow rivers of living water." For Messiah Yeshua's righteousness' sake, grant abundant water. For you are the Lord our God, who causes the wind to blow and the rain to fall, for a blessing and not for a curse, for life and not for death, for plenty and not for. And so we pray for God's blessing. Of course, in the Middle East, rain is a matter of life and death there. And so we pray for rain, and we pray for abundant blessing. We pray for, as I like to call it, the infusion of life, you know, in Israel. And of course, today is a day when we really need to be praying for the rain to fall, so to speak. Because as I'm sure beginning of the service, some of you are not here, I don't know if you've seen the news or anything like that, but war has broken out in Israel, a surprise attack. And a significant one. So we need to be praying for peace. We need to be praying for the peace of Jerusalem. We need to be praying that there would be a stoppage of hostilities. But right now it's escalating as we speak. And, many reserves have been called up, my son among them. And so we don't know what actually is in the future, other than we need to be praying.
Amen.
And that is indeed what we will do. We will do that right now. We pray a traditional prayer that we have for Israel, and then specific prayer that we have. Our Father in heaven, rock and redeemer of the people of Israel, bless the state of Israel and the promise of redemption. Shield.